sunshine throughout. Low humidity. Really a splendid September day. The afternoon temperature about 80 degrees. Great weather for the...
My name is Kurt Sonnenfeld. For 10 years, I worked for several different agencies of the United States government, including the Federal Emergency Management Agency. In September of 2001, I was contracted to be the official videographer following the attacks on Ground Zero of the World Trade Center. Because of the conclusions of what I saw and what I filmed, my life has been in danger for the past 10 years. Now, I live in Argentina as a political refugee. This is my story. I was born in 1962 in Denver, Colorado. My father, Gene, was a project manager for a construction company. I have a brother, Craig, and a sister, Dixie. My mother, Bonnie, stayed at home with us and raised us quite well. I had a very happy childhood. Most of what I remember was outside playing constantly, going to the mountains, skiing, riding horses, typical Colorado activities. After I graduated from high school, I began to attend the University of Colorado in Boulder, Colorado. I studied international relations with a minor in economics and eventually continued to get another bachelor's degree in English with a writing concentration and a minor in philosophy. My career at FEMA began the wife of the systems analyst of the economic journal where I worked had a job with FEMA, and her boss had mentioned to her that that they needed somebody who knew how to write, who knew how to produce television. And she said, I know just the person, and she nominated me. I remember at one point running to catch a helicopter with my camera on my shoulder, eating a sandwich, and my cell phone ringing all at the same time. And I remember thinking, wow, this is a cool job. It's something I want to do. After a while, I began being involved in natural disasters and other catastrophes, including terrorist attacks or accidents at munitions depots, for example. A lot of installations where they develop or storage or transport weapons of mass destruction, including chemical, biological, and nuclear weapons. I've got videotape of what's called ton containers full of VX gas. I've got videotape of the disarming of a nuclear bomb. A lot of situations that are typically characterized as confidential or top secret. Because of the level of confidence that they had in me, on the morning of September 11th, 2001, I was called by my boss at FEMA to travel to New York City to be the official videographer at the perimeter of the World Trade Center.
This is a box of some of my things from FEMA, from my years of responding to catastrophes and disasters. See what we have here.
To me, things began to appear out of the ordinary or even suspicious right from the beginning. All of the government agents were walking freely about on the rubble of Ground Zero. There was no attention at all given to preserving evidence, and in fact, from what it looked like to me, they were very rapidly removing the evidence and taking it away to Fishkill Island, where it was then sent to China and melted down as quickly as possible. To me, the most suspicious thing of all of what happened on September 11th is what happened to Building 7 of the World Trade Center. Very few people know that that in fact three buildings collapsed. This building was not hit by any airplane, didn't have any structural damage as a result of any airplane, or much structural damage as a result of the Twin Towers falling. But amazingly enough, Building 7 fell in a perfect textbook type implosion, taking only 6.5 seconds for a 47-story building to fall completely into its own footprint. This to me indicates that there was absolutely no resistance between the floors when the building collapsed. I was told that I needed to be on call 24 hours a day in case one of the black boxes were discovered. The chances were good that at least one would be found. However, these indestructible black boxes, not even a molecule was found. Supposedly they were vaporized in the collision. But I have footage of the seats of the airplane, landing gear, the rubber tires, aluminum fuselage. A lot of things that are a lot more sensitive to heat and impact than a black box, and yet they somehow managed to survive the collision, whereas the black boxes, oddly enough, did not. One thing I am certain of is that the agencies of intelligence of the United States of America knew what was going to happen and at least let it happen. And considering the unusual events around WTC-7, I'm at the point of concluding that not only did they know it was going to happen, that they in fact collaborated.
Thanks for being here. Appreciate it. Thanks.
On the first day of the year 2002, my wife Nancy took the tragic decision to take her own life. The police came, several of them jumped on top of me and began beating me. I don't like to talk about this. After I was released, and I returned back home, some friends of mine called and said that they had a surprise for me, that they had two uncles who lived in Argentina who each had apartments side by side in a town called San Bernardo, which was on the beach, and they offered to let me stay there as long as I needed.
Yo estaba comiendo con unos amigos cuando lo conocí a Kurt. Él estaba intentando hablar en un español muy de manual, muy malo, un manual malo. Le dijo uno de mis mejores amigos, el típico, where are you from? Y Kurt le dijo, soy norteamericano, no tengo ni idea de nada de Argentina y vine para pasar unos días a descansar, a pensar.
September 11th was approaching. We agreed to do one television show and only not speak of anything controversial, just speak about the heroism and things like that, and just keep it in memory of the victims. However, about 3 days before I was to deliver the original footage, about 20 members of Interpol came charging me in front of my house, threw me up against a wall, threw handcuffs on me, and said that an airplane was waiting to take me back to the United States. They had with them a request from the embassy of Buenos Aires to confiscate all of my documents, all of my video footage, and to remit it immediately back to the United States with the fugitive.
Cuando llegué a Interpol con la orden de detención, todo por el pedido de Estados Unidos, ellos lo hacen salir a Kurt con el pretexto de que le enseñase un policía que estaba en la esquina cómo usar una cámara. Kurt sale de casa y allí emergen de todos lados más de una docena de agentes de Interpol.
What had happened was they had revived the personal tragedy that I had suffered, the suicide of my first wife, Nancy. They used that as a tool to bring me back to the United States, where I was under their control. At least four different courts, four times has my case been looked at by a judge and been decided in my favor. Yet the United States government continues and continues and continues. What we want now is for the United States government to cease what they're doing. My wife and I now have two beautiful daughters. Born here in Argentina, my wife is Argentinian. I now consider myself Argentinian. Of course, I miss my parents very much, my brother and sister very much. I miss the mountains of Colorado. But to me, if I had a chance to go back to the United States, I don't believe I would. I prefer it here.